Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. Are you looking for a place to store your plastic food storage bags? Have you went to go get one and realized you had run out? Well, in this video, I'm gonna share 3 tips on how to organize your plastic food storage bags. I'm standing in my kitchen and this is by the sink area. The stove is behind me. And here is my family room. I watch TV sometimes while I'm cooking or washing dishes. To the right are 3 drawers, and you can see this one is more shallow, and then these are deeper ones. I put kitchen towels in these and some miscellaneous stuff in there. To the left is the cabinet that's under the sink. I'm going to show you this one. This is a drawer where I put our Ziploc, or you can call them plastic baggies. My first tip is to make it convenient. Convenient means involving little trouble or effort. So how is it going to be convenient for you? How is it going to be the least trouble and the least effort? So the first thing you have to ask is, what am I using these bags for? Whether they're plastic storage bags or reusable ones, wherever you're going to put it, you have to make it convenient. So for us, we don't really use these for the fridge or freezer leftovers or for storing food. We actually use different food storage containers. If you want to see that video, I'll link it above. We actually use this for guests when they come over and they want to take food home, or we give food for them to take home. I'm Filipino, or we're Filipino, so we call it baon, which is basically food provisions for a journey or basically takeaway. So I have it here in this drawer, as I said, next to the sink and near the table. And there's even a little spot here where guests can go ahead and put to the storage bags, or I have other countertops for them. So this is convenient for us. I don't want during a party or a dinner for me to say, okay, the Ziploc bags are in the pantry. So I don't want them necessarily opening up my walk-in pantry or another cabinet. I felt like having it here in this drawer is going to be the most convenient for them and for ourselves. So if you use a lot of food storage bags, whether reusable or not, do you want it near where you eat dinner every night? Do you want it near where you prepare lunches? Do you want it in the same cabinet or drawer where all your other lunch containers are? Think about your lifestyle, what works for you and your family. My second tip is to make them accessible. So what does that mean? It means that you're able to put your hand in, grab what you need, and take it out, okay? Without having to fumble through it, without having to rummage, without having to take one and then a whole bunch of them come out. So the way I've done it is I've put them in these rectangular acrylic containers or drawer organizers. And I've used a label maker, a lime one, and labeled them the size of the bag. You can always keep them in the box. That's not necessarily what makes them inaccessible, but you can always take off the flap or the cover to the box so that it's easy to grab things and take them out. Another thing to think about as far as making it accessible is, are you putting it in a deep drawer? So you found a place that's convenient, now it has to be accessible. If it is a deep drawer, so obviously mine is not deep, but if yours is a deep drawer and there are boxes laying on top of each other, you don't necessarily see what's underneath it, right? You'd have to take one out and take another one out or whatever you're doing. So a great way to store food storage bags that are still in boxes is to make them vertical. So going down this way. So when you're looking above and you open your drawer, you can see which box has which bag. My third tip is to put them in order. So I have snack, sandwich, quart storage, quart freezer, and gallon freezer. So for me, the way I naturally think, and maybe most of you, is to put the smaller, okay, and storage to freezer. So you can put it in whatever order works best for you. In my mind, I like snack, then sandwich. Over here is quart storage, and then quart freezer, and gallon freezer. Now, I don't have gallon storage, but if I want to, I can always slip them in here, but I found that it's not any big difference, at least for us, so I'd rather just have the freezer ones. And then these covers, they're basically, what are those called? Those caps for your hair. And I use them sometimes to cover bowls. And as I said, these little jewelry bags. So here I've labeled it covers. And then I have zip ties here. And I've just used a twist tie to corral them. So those are my 3 points. Number one is to make them convenient. Number two is to make them accessible. And number three is to put them in order. I really like this system. I've had this system for a few years already, and it works for us. It works for when I have guests over, as I said earlier. So I just keep the same system because it is completely working and functional for us. I like the way this looks, so if that's important to you, keep that in mind when you're organizing your food storage bags. Question of the day, where do you keep your food storage bags? I'd love to know in the comments below. I read all your comments and reply to them. If you're new to this channel and you want more home organizing and hospitality tips, then hit that subscribe button and the bell notification, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.